And today we're going to be reviewing Joe Bigo's newest film, VFW. VFW is the Expendables on neon-soaked acid. This film is ridiculous. It is balls-to-the-wall action from beginning to end. It is a really great addition, in my opinion, to the classic grindhouse horror genre. And it's scuzzy, and it's disgusting, and it's dirty, but all of that's on purpose. The way that it's filmed, everything about it just comes off as like that old grizzled classic grindhouse feel. There's so much going on in this film, even though there's so little going on. And let me explain that. There's a simplistic plot to this film, which is a bunch of veterans are trying to protect this girl that stumbles into a bar after she steals a whole bunch of drugs. That is the context point of this film. That's the narrative that we're going along with, and that's a pretty simplistic, unoriginal plot, but they use that to their advantage, VFW does, and Joe Bigos uses that to his advantage, because this film allows the characters to shine a lot more because of its simplistic plot. There's not a whole bunch of crazy, you know, uninhabitable, unintelligible shit going on in this film. There's a lot of stuff that you can fully understand. You know, there's a very simple plot. It's straightforward. You know what's happening. So now you got to focus on something else. So you focus on those characters. And those characters that they have are likable. Incredibly likable characters. I actually enjoyed every single one of them. Not one character felt out of place. Not one character did I not like. Other than the villains. I did not like the villains. And that's the point. You're not supposed to like the villains. And they made a very unlikable villain. He was a little one note for my taste, but he wasn't, you know, terrible. And he does his job well enough to where you don't like him, you want to see him get his comeuppance, and he's still a bit one note, but that's okay. And you can forgive that because of just how crazy this film is. Because the real star of this film is not its characters. Although the characters are good and likable, and that is an important factor in a film, and the character development isn't too bad, and they're pretty well written. The real star of VFW is its practical VFX work, which is fantastic and adds a lot of charm and heart to the film that you just couldn't get with something like a, let's say, You Should Have Left. I just watched a modern horror film that felt kind of like a 2000s film. And You Should Have Left, you know, lost me. Where You Should Have Left lost me because of how much it didn't care about its story or characters. VFW uses such a simple plot in order to get you engaged in its characters. And the way that they set up these characters, in the situation that they're in, you have to root for them. And everyone has, you know, clear motivations. And my favorite character in this film has to be Stephen Lang's character, because Stephen Lang in this film is so likable. The guy is like the captain of the team. He's all trying to get his men fired up, trying to, you know, help this person out. And he's such a great character. He takes no nonsense off people, but he's also so funny. And they throw these things around somewhat, and I really just liked what they did with him in this film. They just gave him a platform to you know, act off of, and he takes a decent script and makes it better than it was because of his great performance. He really steals the show in this one, and that is to be assumed, because that guy can really act, and I learned that a lot more when I watched Don't Breathe a few years back by Fed Alvarez. And when he played the blind man, holy, he was intense. And in this film, he's intense, but he's also likable. And I never thought I'd see Stephen Lang in a film and not see, you know, the blind man from Don't Breathe. But he made that character into his own. And I liked the character of Fred. It really kept me interested in the film. And there's a lot of great performances here. And there's a stellar cast, so that is to be expected. William Sadler is the heart and soul of this film, and he's great. Fred Williamson comes back. Great to see him back again. And like I said, you got Stephen Lang, you got Martin Cove. There's a lot of veteran talent, pardon the pun, on the helm of the acting side of this film. And even Sierra McCormick gives a pretty decent performance as Lizard. Do I think that this film is groundbreaking? Is VFW a groundbreaking film? Or does it have anything new to say in the grindhouse horror genre? No, it doesn't. It has a very simplistic, unoriginal plot. But what it loses in a simplistic, unoriginal plot, it makes up for once again in its practical VFX work and its tremendous acting as far as, you know, what they were given with the limitations of the script and everything. Yeah, it makes up for it, some good performances. It makes up for it with good performances, practical VFX work, and just overall some beautiful cinematography. Not to mention there's a killer synth score that really complements the film. And Joe Beagle's direction cannot go unstated, as it is solid. But it is not anything that you haven't seen before here. That being said, it's still very much so something that I believe is a wonderful addition to the already growing classic grindhouse horror genre, which is making a comeback. Stuff like Mandy I would put up there in that grindhouse horror genre. And I think that they deliver. I really do. If you're a fan of those Survive the Night horror films, like Assault on Precinct 13 by John Carpenter, you know, They Live. If you're a fan of The Expendables, this is like the horror equivalent. There's just a lot of different, you know, homages, a lot of different things that I felt they threw in there. This is a bit of a love letter to Grindhouse in a lot of ways. And I think that they deliver tremendously with most of what they're trying to do. Does the film miss the mark a couple of times? And is it a bit boring because you've definitely seen this before? Yeah, some of this film feels like we've seen this 100 times over. But the action keeps you engaged enough, and the characters are likable enough that you can excuse that for once. Because the film is still enjoyable to watch. And it's still something you can go back to and show some friends and just, like, enjoy yourself, I guess. It really depends. If you're someone of a faint of heart, I do not recommend this film. It's very gory. It's very balls-to-the-wall action. It's relentless in what it tries to do. You are going to be uncomfortable. If you like classic grindhouse horror, if you like crazy, violent, gory action films, this is right up your alley. So it really depends on the type of person you are, and it really depends on what you want to do on a Saturday night. Just for example, if you're more of a contemporary drama guy that wants a really great, deep story, I don't recommend this one. If you're looking to have a fun night with your friends and just watch something batshit crazy, VFW is definitely for you. Even if you want to watch something batshit crazy on your own, it's definitely for you. So, what do I think about VFW as a whole overall? I believe the film's pretty solid. I'm gonna give it a 7 out of 10. I think there are definitely problems with it, but there are also great things about it too. And like any film, there's going to be problems with it. But do I think it's a perfect film? No. Do I think it's a great addition to the classic grindhouse horror genre? Hell yes. And do I recommend it? I do recommend it. Do I definitely recommend it? Does it get my full seal of approval? No. But do I recommend it to at least give it a watch to see if it's your thing? Hell yeah, I do. Because I enjoyed this film, and I thought it was a solid, solid film from Joe Bigos, and he's made me a fan. I didn't know about him before this. I definitely want to check out his other work. If it's as crazy as this, you'll be getting some more reviews from me. That being said, like I said, is the film perfect? No, no film is perfect. But did I have problems with this film? Yeah. Like I said, simple. We're going to go through it one more time. Simple, unoriginal plot. And although the pacing seems relentless, it starts out very slow. I know that's to try and build up characters, but really that's just a bunch of people talking at a bar. And then, wow, everything goes nuts. And I understand that was the setup, but like, it just feels like if you're going to go full relentless, go full relentless, goes balls to the wall all the time. Don't try and, like, I knew what I was getting myself into with this film, but they try and add depth, even more depth to the characters than they already have. We already know enough about the characters to where I know where we're going, I know what you're trying to do with this film. If you try and make it more serious, if you try and add even a little more character development to this film, you start dragging down its pacing, you start dragging down the narrative. The narrative is survive the night, save the this girl that's in trouble, we're a bunch of army veterans. Okay, I can go with you on that plot, and I know this is about to be this batshit crazy action film that's going to go all over the place. It's going to be gory, it's going to be gutsy, it's going to be filled with heart. I know that I'm not expecting, like, you know, insane amounts of character development. Because I'm enjoying the action and I'm enjoying what's happening on screen. And you already set up at least likable characters that I can get behind without knowing way too much about them. Because they try and make you care even more about these characters and make them feel even more important. But right now, I already felt for them. I've already liked their characters. I already wanted to see them get out of there. But you try and add even more emotional depth, and usually I'm okay with this, but it kind of just dragged the entire film's pacing down. That being said, that's why I'm giving VFW a 7 out of 10. I still recommend it. It's on VOD right now. I'd recommend you check it out and show Joe Bigos and the studio some support, because a lot of these films are not being made anymore. And they're dying off. They are a dying breed. And it's sad because they're starting to make a comeback, but they might die off again. And a lot of people don't really like that classic grindhouse horror anymore. And a lot of people do. It's more of a cult thing, and it's very, very like a cultish film thing where it's like people like it, but there's not enough people to where it's ever going to make a giant comeback. But, you know, these filmmakers, they still want to try and bring that art form back. And they still want to try and keep that classic horror genre alive. So I highly recommend that if you're a fan of Grindhouse, you check it out. But if you're not a fan of Grindhouse and you just want something batshit crazy, I recommend this. I only highly recommend it if you're already a very, very seasoned fan and love Grindhouse horror. If not, you're taking a risk, and you might like it, you might not, so I'm only going to recommend it. Anyways, guys, this has been Josh from the Review Brothers. 7 out of 10 from me, VFW. Go check it out. It's on VOD. Like, comment, and subscribe. Peace.